Once you have a campaign configured, it's time to focus on setting up your ad groups. And your ad groups contain your keywords, ads, and even the bids that you'll be managing. Now, each time you set up a campaign, Google is going to walk you through the campaign wizard step by step. And that includes everything from creating the ad group to the ads. And you'll be able to leave this at any point and always resume. And you'll also be able to add additional ad groups, ads, and even change settings once you've finished working through the wizard. Now, we saved a campaign which shows up as a draft on our overview page. This would also appear on our All Campaigns page. And I simply need to select Resume Draft from Overview to jump back in where we left off. So we're here at the first step of creating an ad group, which is to develop the keywords. And we can see where we are by using that left-hand navigation and seeing keywords highlighted here in blue. Now, before we jump into keywords, let's start by giving this ad group a name. I'll select the pencil icon, and that will allow us to change this ad group name. Now, because you'll have many ad groups under each of your campaigns, you'll want to create very specific names. Let's call this the Lands and Hotel Winter Discount Offer. And because we're going to be creating multiple offers, I'll call this one 25% off. So now I know that this ad group is offering the 25% off discount. And then we can even include the location, which will be San Francisco. And then from here, I'm going to add another pipe, and I want to think beyond just the discount and beyond just San Francisco, how I'm grouping all of these keywords. And this could be general hotel searches, this could be attractions, this could be amenities. In this case, I'm just going to consider this general hotel. Now, again, this is simply an example, but I want you to think about how to create really specific and tightly themed ad group names. Next, we need to enter in the keywords that are going to trigger our ads for this ad group. And Google is going to automatically suggest a few directly from our website. Here we can see they've suggested our hotel name, pet rooms, the Landon Hotel in London, and so on. Now, these might not be relevant, in which case I can simply remove them, and I can put in San Francisco hotel deals, because this is more related to what this ad group is going to be about. Now, here on the right-hand side, you're going to start to see Google create some daily estimates. And this will adjust as you add more information. Here we can see we're expected to get about a click per day. It's going to cost us $2.12 per day. And this is probably not very realistic. This is not enough keywords to really generate enough traffic for Google to provide us valuable estimates. Now, we've also already restricted this campaign to only run within San Francisco. So including the San Francisco modifier in the keyword might not actually be necessary. We can also try hotel deals near me. And again, on the right-hand side, we can see that this will continue to adjust the daily estimates. Now, again, this isn't going to necessarily be the most accurate, but it is helpful to give you a sense of where you're tracking within the keywords that you're creating. Now, within the ad groups wizard, you can also get additional keyword ideas. So if I enter in products or services here at the top, I can choose update keywords, and Google is going to automatically replace all of the keywords related. Now, receiving those suggestions can actually be a little bit overwhelming. And you typically want to be coming into your ad group creation already knowing how you want to theme those keywords and the plan that you've already developed. So it might make more sense to use the keyword planner to generate those ideas and then bring them in to the ad group. Now, it's here that you'll also be using those match types. And Google's going to remind you what the match types are at the bottom of this keyword block. So if we wanted to say that hotel deals has to be an exact match, I would simply add brackets around hotel deals. And we should see now on the right-hand side that that exact match has really restricted the targeting of this campaign. But once you start running your campaigns, you're going to be getting real data that will influence how you'll be evolving this campaign from here. And at this point, you've now created your first ad group, and Google's going to take you to the next step, which is creating the ads themselves.